Okay, good afternoon all. So welcome to our engineering physics. I am going to discuss acoustics. Before going to discuss this acoustics, so characteristics of musical sound. I don't want to explain about noise further, but musical sound, that is useful. So characteristics of musical sound, characteristics of musical sound, you can see here. The musical sound is divided into three types. Number one is pitch or frequency. Number two, quality or timbre. And last one, loudness or intensity. So you can see on the screen, pitch, number two, quality or timbre, number three, loudness or intensity. What is pitch? What is the definition of pitch? The characteristics of musical sound by which we can differentiate between a shrill sound and a dull sound of the same intensity is called pitch. If we take two sound waves, we can differentiate sounds that intensity. Both are having same intensity, that is pitch or frequency. What is that definition? The characteristics of musical sound by which we can differentiate between a shrill and a dull sound of the same intensity, that is called pitch. You can see on the screen, same definition you can see on the screen. The characteristics of musical sound by which we can differentiate between shrill and dull sound of the same intensity, that is called pitch. That is the pitch or frequency. The pitch is the characteristics of musical sound, which depends upon the frequency. So the pitch is directly proportional to frequency. Frequency value increases, pitch value also increases. If we are increasing our tone frequency, the pitch also increases. You can see the pitch is the characteristics of a musical sound, which depends upon the frequency. The sound with low frequency is low pitch. If high frequency is high pitch. These are able sounds. We can listen able sounds. The sound with low frequency is the pitch able sound, and the sound with high frequency is high pitch. That is also able sound. It is the characteristics of a musical sound which depends upon frequency. Already I told, it depends on the frequency of the source. The pitch depends upon the frequency of the source. With increased frequency, the pitch becomes higher, making the note more and more shrill. So frequency and pitch depending on each other. The pitch is directly proportional to frequency. Frequency value increases, pitch value also increases, means it becomes higher. The sound with low frequency is low pitch able sound, and the sound with high frequency is high pitch able sound. If low frequency, low pitch, high frequency, high pitch, we observe. Greater the frequency of musical note, higher is the pitch. It is the sensation conveyed to brain. Very, very important point. It is the sensation. The pitch is the sensation conveyed to the brain by the sound waves falling on the ears. So the pitch and frequency both are depending on each other, but these are not same values. The pitch is the sensation only. It will change from person to person. it will be changed person to person. So the pitch is the sensation, only sensation conveyed to the brain by the sound waves falling on the ears. Ears, you can observe here. Pitch is the characteristics of sound, which is the sensation conveyed to our brain by the sound waves falling in our ears. The pitch depends directly on the frequency of the incident sound wave. But the pitch and frequency both are not same in general. Frequency is the physical quantity we can measure accurately. Frequency is a physical quantity. That physical quantity we can measure accurately. Frequency means the number of oscillations per second or the number of vibrations per second. So we can measure in hertz. We can measure that frequency in hertz. But pitch we cannot measure, because this is a physiological quantity or psychological quantity. Only it conveyed our brain by the sound waves falling on our ear. What I am saying, the pitch and frequency both are not same. Frequency is a physical quantity. Pitch is a physiological quantity. So frequency we can measure, but pitch we cannot measure, because it is a psychological quantity or physiological quantity. So example we can see, you know very well, mosquito and lion compared to each other, mosquito very simple, lion it is a big animal, you can see. So sound of mosquito produces high pitch value. You know very well, at the time of night, at the sleeping time, you can also observe. Sound of mosquito produces high pitch. The sound of lion, low pitch compared to mosquito. Mosquito. Sound of mosquito produces high pitch than the sound of lion, which is a low pitch. Low pitch value. So why the voice of men is deep and the voice of women and children is sharp? Sharp. I gave this yesterday. So what is the reason? There are two types of membranes, our vocal, which are known as vocal cords. So every woman has vocal cords. Depending on these vocal cords, the vocal cords are vibrating, then we can speak some words. We have no vocal cords, we cannot speak. So depending on these vocal cords, we can speak. If the vocal cord is thick, we observe deep sound. If it is thin, we observe some sharp sound. You can see here, there are two types of membranes in our vocal, which are known as vocal cords. The sound is produced due to the vibration of vocal cords, and so people can speak. Due to the different harmonics present in the voices, we can characterize of sounds are called quality or timbre. Depending on this quality and timbre, we can discuss. So answer, you can observe here, simple answer, the vocal cords of adult men become thick as they age, but the vocal cords of children and women are not thick. So the adult men vocal cords are very thick compared to children and women. So the children and women are not thick vocal cords. For this, the frequency of voice of the adult men is less frequency, and the frequency of voice of women and children is more. So the voice of men is deep, but the voice of children and women is sharp. So what I am saying here, the adult men has thick vocal cords. Thick vocal cords. So the frequency of voice of the adult, less frequency. They are producing less frequency. So it has deep sound we can absorb. So the women and children, the frequency more. So the voice of men is deep, but the voice of children and women is sharp. The vocal cords of adult men become thick, and children, women are not thick. Very thin vocal cords they are having. For this, the frequency of voice of the adult men is less, and the frequency of voice of women and children is more. So the voice of men is deep, but the voice of children and women is sharp. So this is general. What is quality or timbre? Already I discussed about pitch. So second one, quality and timbre. What is quality? What is timbre? So you can see here a definition. The characteristics of musical sound by which we can differentiate between two sound waves of the same intensity and same pitch. What I am saying, just to take two sound waves. These two sound waves compulsory, both are having same intensity and same pitch, then we can differentiate. So first one value is equal to second wave value, we get some quality between two waves. Between two waves. If you are differentiating between two sound waves, these are having same intensity, same pitch. If we are characterizing that two waves, if we get the same value, it has perfect quality or timbre. The characteristics of musical sound by which we can differentiate between two sounds of the same intensity and pitch is called quality or timbre. Timbre. So it measures the complexity of sound. Quality measure the complexity of sound. The quality of sound depends upon the number and intensity of harmonics, harmonic oscillation, regular periodic, so periodic repeating motion. So we get in sound waves also we get regular periodic, that is musical sound, that is harmonic sound, harmonic. So the quality of sound depends upon the number and intensity of harmonics. The number, for example, F0, 2F0, 3F0, and so on. That is harmonic frequencies. Harmonic frequencies you can see on the screen. It measures the complexity of sound. Quality of sound depends upon the number and intensity of harmonics. The quality of sound or timbre depends upon number and what number? The frequency number, F0, 2F0, 3F0, and so on. So, and intensity of harmonics. Intensity of harmonics, different intensities we can present. Intensity. We are producing different frequencies values. The number of frequencies, F0, intensity, F0, 2F0, 3F0. So F0, that is fundamental frequency, 2F0, 2 into fundamental. So first, second, third harmonics. First, second, and third harmonics. Try to understand, very simple. The quality of sound depends upon the number of harmonics and the intensity of harmonics. Intensity of harmonics. So just definition and quality depends upon number of harmonics and number of intensities. Only I discussed two points here. Only two points. You can observe, I am giving this ball pen. you can observe. So just you remember this definition. So the characteristics of musical sound by which we can differentiate, okay, so you remember this, between two sound waves of the same intensity and same pitch. Next, just you remember it depends upon number of harmonics. Number of harmonics and intensity of harmonics. So number of harmonics, these are the number of harmonics. F0, 2F0, 3F0 and so on. F0 is called fundamental frequency or starting frequency. So F0, 2F0, 3F0, what is this? First, second and third harmonics. Harmonics. You can observe on the screen. Okay. So just you remember definition. The quality of sound depends upon the number of harmonics and the intensity of harmonics present in the sound. A pure sound produces comparatively less pleasing effect on ears than sound consisting of a number of harmonics. Number of harmonics, different harmonics, different frequencies. You can also observe in flute, in violin, the frequency value changes F0 to F0, 3F0 and so on. So harmonics, rhythmic changing. Sarigama Padanisa. So they will change their sound depending on this harmonics and intensity harmonics. They will change. So we will get some quality music. Quality of sound depends upon the number of harmonics and intensity of harmonics. The number of harmonics are given by F0, 2F0, 3F0 and so on, etc. F0 is the fundamental frequency. The F0, 2F0, 3F0 and so on, etc. are first, second, third and so on harmonics. In the voice of different pupils, different harmonics are present. Person to person, that harmonics changes, the frequency changes depending on vocal cords, it will change. So I will change sound from one to another one. In the voice of different pupils, different harmonics are present. I can also change some frequency values due to the, so we will change that sound, that music, depending on frequency change. So frequency change. Due to the different harmonics present in the voices, we characteristics of sound are called quality or timbre. So the characteristics, what characteristics, what type of characteristics, due to the different harmonics present in the voices, if we are characterized of sound are called quality or timbre. This is second definition. So the harmonics changes person to person, from some candidate to another candidate, it will change. If we are characterized, this harmonics of sound are called quality or timbre. Quality or timbre. Timbre. So this is the characteristics of musical sound by which we can differentiate between two sounds of the same intensity and pitch is called quality or timbre. So intensity or loudness, you can see on the screen. Intensity is a physical quantity and hence it is measurable. Loudness is a psychological quantity, hence it is not measurable. You can see definition. It is defined as, first of all, you see, so here intensity I is equal to Q by T into A. So you define this is energy. The ratio of, you see here, ratio. The ratio of energy. Ratio of energy. What is that? Q. Flowing per unit second. Up to here, this is Q. Flowing per unit second, this is T. Unit area, this is A. So just see that formula, you can define. It is defined as the ratio of sound energy flowing per unit second to unit area at a point, that is called intensity. Intensity, you can define, or simply, so Q by T, you can see here, power P is equal to work per second, or work is also treated as some energy, Q by T. So we can write Q by T is equal to P. So this is P by A. P is the power. Power per unit area at a point is called intensity. So two definitions we can discuss. It is defined as the ratio of sound energy flowing per unit second to unit area at a point held normal to the direction of the propagation of sound waves are called intensity. Or the ratio between power to the surface area is also called intensity. Or power per unit area at a point is also called intensity. Intensity. So the unit of the intensity is given by watt per meter square. Watt per meter square. For example, you see this is power. Power unit watt, area meter square. So we can write this is watt per meter square. Or here energy joule by time second. So this is area meter square. We can write joule per second per meter square. That is the unit. Let Q be the energy of sound, and it is produced by the source of area capital A. Therefore, the intensity of sound wave is given by I is equal to Q by TA. Already I have explained. So where small t is the time. Similarly, the intensity of sound in terms of power also I wrote here I is equal to P by A. I is equal to P by A. Already I wrote here, you can observe. You can observe. So that is I is equal to P by A. Where P is equal to Q by T. Also you can see here, P is equal to Q by T. So loudness is a psychological quantity. What I am saying at the starting, I told this is intensity is a physical quantity we can measure. But loudness, capital L, loudness is a psychological quantity. It is defined as the degree of sensation produced on the ears. And it depends on the listener. So loudness. Some person feeling it is very loud. It is very simple sound. So depending on listener, it will change or it will be changed. It is defined as the degree of sensation produced on the ears, and it depends upon the listener. Therefore, it is difficult to measure accurately since it depends on the individual listener. Individual listener. So Weber, Fechner law. Weber Fechner law in intensity and loudness. So that principle you can see on the screen. Loudness capital L is directly proportional to logarithm of intensity I capital I. So capital L loudness proportionality constant K log I. We can also write. So proportionality constant K log I. So what is that? Loudness and intensity of sound waves are related to each other by the Weber and Fechner law. We can also see L related to I. According to this law, the loudness capital L of the source of the sound is directly proportional to the logarithm of intensity. Intensity. So greater the intensity of sound wave, greater the loudness. Simply directly proportional to. So I is more, L also more. Loudness in intensity depends on amplitude, surface area, distance between sources and listener density. Listener density of the medium. Of the medium. You can see, according to your intermediate knowledge, the intensity is equal to 2 pi square n square a square dc. You have studied in light waves in your intermediate. It we can also apply the this is light waves intensity. Sound waves intensity we can apply. So I is equal to 2 pi square n square as it is amplitude square d. This is velocity, where v is the velocity of sound in air. So that value you know very well, 330 meter per second. You studied in your intermediate. But see, this is velocity of light. Velocity of light. So this is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. You know very well. But remaining N, A, D, both are all are same. N is the frequency. A is the amplitude. D is the density. See, light wave or light velocity, V, velocity of sound. So the intensity depends upon amplitude, A, surface area, small a, distance. For example, distance, take L, another distance, B, L into B, we can write area, area. Small a. So it depends upon this distance. Amplitude also some distance. So this distance and other distance, it gives some area. So it depends upon surface area, distance between sources, listener, density. You can see density. So density of medium, air velocity. So that is air. It depends upon, the intensity depends upon these factors. Amplitude, surface area, distance between sources, and listener, density of medium and air. So you can see here, intensity of a sound wave, intensity of a sound wave. The intensity of sound is defined as the average rate transfer of sound energy per unit area. So already I discussed this is Q by T into A. This is rate of energy, Q by T. So average rate of transfer of sound energy. So this is rate of energy simple per unit area. You can observe. So I is equal to Q by T into A. According to this formula, we can define average rate transfer of sound energy and Q by T. So that is Q by T per unit area, capital A. Even though intensity is a physical quantity to measure absolutely, already we discussed. The relative intensity measurement is widely used for practical purpose. So intensity we can measure, it is used in laboratory. So the standard intensity for threshold audible value is 1000 Hz. The standard intensity, what is standard intensity value? So standard intensity value, you can see so this is CGS unit, CGS, this is in SI. So watt per meter square, watt per meter square, just you remember this value, 10 to the power minus 12 watt per meter square, or in centimeter square, that is 10 to the power minus 16 watt per centimeter square. So threshold standard audible frequency 1000 Hz. Simply standard intensity value 10 to the power minus 12 Weber per meter square. Weber per meter square. So this is Weber's Fechner's law. You can see here intensity, I am discussing again intensity or loudness. So I is equal to Q by T into A. You can see here, this is the formula. So this is energy, this is second time, this is area. It is defined as the ratio of sound energy flowing per unit second to unit area at a point is called intensity. So the formula is given by I is equal to Q by T into A. So this is Q joule, time second, area A square. So this is meter square. We can write this is joule for second per meter square. So Q by T, we can write I is equal to P by A. So P power watt, area meter square. So we can write watt per meter square. Where small t is the time. Similarly, the intensity of sound in terms of power P is given by I is equal to P by A, where P is equal to Q by T. Loudness is a psychological quantity. Intensity is a physical quantity. We can measure accurately, but loudness we cannot measure accurately. So you can see here Weber-Fechner's law. Loudness and intensity of sound waves are related to each other by the Fechner-Weber law, because L is directly proportional to log I. The loudness is directly proportional to logarithm of intensity of sound. That is Weber-Fechner's law. So the Weber-Fechner's law depends upon loudness and intensity. The Weber-Fechner's law shows the variation between loudness and intensity of sound wave. If intensity value increases, loudness also increases. It depends upon amplitude, surface area, distance between sources, and listener density of medium and air. Intensity of sound wave the intensity of sound wave, again I am discussing Q by T. So average rate of transfer of sound energy per unit area, that is called intensity. Intensity. The threshold intensity standard value, 1000 Hz. The intensity we can measure absolutely, so it is used in laboratories. The standard threshold intensity value, 1000 Hz. The standard intensity value, 10^-12 Weber per meter square, or 10^-16 Weber per centimeter square. Centimeter square.